Welcome to the program, What About Homelessness? And I'm your host, Joseph Flamm. Of course, as you all know, the intention is to put the issue of homelessness out into the public, increase awareness, and to provide a vehicle for some positive change with regards to homelessness. We have a guest in the studio today. Bethany Bowers, the Executive Director of Family Promise. Welcome to the program.
Thank you for having me.
Very excited to have you on, of course. And we tried for about 3 or 4 months, but we got here, right?
We finally got here.
We got here, so that's a good thing. Yes. So I suppose if you may explain who you are.
Sure.
And then, of course, what Family Promise is involved with.
Sure. I won't talk about myself too long. I'm a newbie to Family Promise. I have been the executive director at Family Promise of Berks for about 9 months. I do have a little bit of history with Family Promise. I've interned there in graduate school and my undergraduate school, and I had been serving on the board for about 2 years prior to making the transition. So won't bore you again with myself. So we'll move on to Family Promise, which is why we're all here, right? So Family Promise is a small nonprofit organization in Berks County. We've been around for about 15 years. We are part of a larger national network. So there are many Family Promises throughout the country. And our main focus is on serving families that are experiencing homelessness and young adults and youth that are experiencing homelessness. Our mission is to help families and youth achieve sustainable independence. And we really believe that in order to tackle that and to alleviate homelessness, we must call upon the community, right? And our partners in the community to make that happen.
Excellent. So what was mentioned from the top, the Berks County Family Promise I think in my research there's at least 200 affiliates throughout the country. Not in every state, however, but most of them. Mm-hmm. And this presently, if I recall correctly, well over 800,000 to 900,000 families have been, or individuals, I may have misspoke, but have benefited from the Family Promise.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's very, very involved.
Yeah. Yeah, we do, we're a mighty small force, is what I think. Small but mighty. We do have 3 core programs. One of our program assists families who are experiencing homelessness. We currently have 2 homes that provide home-like shelter services for the families. Families do need to have children in order to be eligible, but we really take in families of any dynamic, single family, single parent families, grandparents who are taking care of their grandchildren. And they can stay in the program for about 60 to 90 days. And the end goal is permanent housing, right? To be working towards that goal of permanent housing. Our second core program is a rent and utilities assistance program. So we currently receive funding. It's sent down from the federal government, right? But then administered by the county. And then we can help folks that live outside of the city of Reading if they're behind on rent or utilities. There's a human relations commission that will help folks in the city. So don't worry, folks in the city can also apply for this funding, but with another entity. And then our third core program is working with 17 to 24 year olds that are experiencing homelessness.
So those are the 3 programs.
Those are the 3 core programs.
And,
yep.
And could you explain them a little more?
Sure.
Involved each one of you.
Sure.
Like.
So for the services for families who are experiencing homelessness, we call that the hospitality network. Historically, Family Promise in Berks and National had partnered with about 25 to 30 different faith-based organizations in our local community.
Wow.
And for about 15 years, really, from when we started, churches would volunteer their spaces and their facilities And families would stay overnight in churches, and the volunteers at the churches would feed them dinner, spend time with them, provide amazing hospitality. And that was, again, it was a 60-day program. And as you can imagine, when COVID hit, some of the first public facilities to shut down were churches. So we had to very quickly evolve and change because of the needs of families. There were still families experiencing homelessness, right, through COVID. And so we currently work with Berks Redevelopment Authority. They own two homes.
Interesting.
Yep, and we pay the rent and utilities there, and we can take anywhere from 3 to 5 families at a time and stay for 60 to 90 days with the sole purpose of permanent housing. Our rent and utilities, we can help people who live outside of the city. If they have a court-ordered eviction, we need some other documents. So those are really the two qualifications, court-ordered eviction or utility shutoff, and that they live outside of the city, and then there's an application process. And we can offer them to get them caught up with their rent, so they're not behind anymore. I know before I came onto the show, I wanted to, really just mention some successes and outcomes that I want to help people put this into perspective.
Very good.
So for 2022, so far this year, it's hard to believe we're in April already, right?
Yeah, no doubt.
Right. And then in the past 3 months of this year alone, through the Rent and Utilities Assistance Program, we have assisted 24 families with rental assistance. And what that means is we helped prevent 24 families from experiencing homelessness.
That's great.
Yeah.
And of course, one family is one too many.
Yeah, I agree.
There's no doubt about that.
I agree. We also helped, just in this year, 9 families find housing. And that's called our Rapid Rehousing Program. So we help with homeless prevention, which are the 24 families that I mentioned that we prevented from being evicted, right, and becoming homeless. And the rapid rehousing is when we help folks who identify as homelessness, what have you, right, if they're doubling up or if they're currently in a homeless shelter. We can help financially move into a place, into permanent housing. So we helped 9 folks so far this year get into housing. So I think that's pretty fantastic. I think they do a lot of great work.
Oh, it is. It is, no doubt about that. Now, I also in my research read that about 80% of the people who get involved within 9 weeks, they have housing. That's quite extraordinary.
Yeah, and more specifically, the folks who have gone through our program last year in our hospitality network, or the family shelter, if you will, about 90% of them obtained permanent housing. Some of them even purchased their first home, right? One of the other things, Joe, I heard you say earlier, we need to continue to have conversations, right, about homelessness.
Right.
And I really believe that, we need to change systems. I believe that we need to make a workable wage where people aren't put in positions where they're feeling like they can't afford their rent or their utilities. But I also think that we need to change the public narrative around homelessness, right?
Yes.
I think we certainly create a picture in our minds about factors that can lead to homeless. And while many of them may be accurate, or some of them may be accurate, they're not all accurate. We've worked with many families in our programs who had experienced house fires, right? And so they were in our shelter. And so I put that out there to all of you just to also to think about homelessness in the context of human worth and dignity, right? That many of us are one paycheck away, right? Or one resource away from experiencing this, right?
No doubt about that. In my conversations with people, knowing the story that I have personally, I've learned quite often that people have a view of what homelessness involves. Mm-hmm. It's not always favorable, mm-hmm. you know, and some of that's understandable, of course, but we all have our hardship and adversity, and as you mentioned, Bethany, earlier, it can happen very quickly, and if you don't have, you're not knowing about programs such as yours, mm-hmm. and you don't have the support and encouragement, something I like to mention briefly at least is we all are more or less familiar how the families in America have declined, where you have a huge divorce rate and you have all these issues, and that's of course what you see a lot of, mm-hmm. you know, that people are separating there if they're even together at all, and in those circumstances it's and you have some hardship, whatever that may be, it can go completely south very very quickly. Mm-hmm. So a really really big piece of all of this is the family structure, and whatever that might be, you know, because it's not the same for everybody, and also, to your point, for sure, that people have this idea about what homelessness is. Mm-hmm. Quite often, I come across they are taken. Taken aback by how people get in these situations, and it can in fact happen to all of us. Mm-hmm. And there's very notable people who are doing quite well now, mm-hmm. who were homeless and perhaps for a while. Mm-hmm. And it's so involved. We've had people on the program and to talk about, and we're going to continue to do this, of course. That's what we're doing here. We're going to continue to put the subject of homelessness out into the public, mm-hmm. for one reason would be what you talked about, that people become familiar with what's going on here. You know, I've always been super impressed by the amount. In fact, this comment was just made to me yesterday. How huge this is, the involvement from the community, particularly Berks County is very giving, and it's just really extraordinary how many people are involved in the great things they're doing. It's very uplifting. Mm-hmm. There's just so much compassion out there, and we need to tap into that. Huh? Mm-hmm. But it's not my view. My own personal view is, we're always going to have issues in society, from the beginning of time, you know. But so whereas we may not totally do away with what we're talking about here, homelessness, we can prevent a lot of it, a lot of the people from coming into that circumstance. But also once they do, that they get involved in programs, whatever they may be, and they have a much brighter future. So there's so much involved here, you know, the education, knowing what's available. I know myself, I was clueless, really, mm-hmm. basically clueless, come from a middle-class family, and, you know, it's not something that you think you're going to be involved with, but I'm blessed with all of it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's been eye-opening, to say the least, and it's been great.
Yeah.
But we need to, as you said, change that view, mm-hmm. with a lot of people, mm-hmm. you know, because it's not always favorable.
Yeah, yeah, and especially and, you know, when we work with children, and we work with the population of young adults and youth, some 17 and 18 year olds are oftentimes being kicked out of their homes for not a whole significant, you know, not a significant reason, or it's just, you know, it's time for you to be on your own. We actually work with, you know, some younger adults in their early 20s who, when we meet with them and talk and define homelessness or unaccompanied youth to them, they often say, you know, I experienced homelessness when I was 17 also, and I wish that I knew you were here. And so I think what's, you know, I appreciate you for doing the TV show, and I appreciate your focus on awareness, because I do believe that we need to put it out there, right? And we need to have conversations, and we need to let people know that there is support out there. And if it's not with Family Promise, then we'll help them find it, right? So that there is support out there and there is compassion out there.
Right. And that's so very important. Mm-hmm. You know, there's so many takeaways from the homeless issue. You know, I certainly the compassionate and the caring, mm-hmm. you know, the giving and the sharing that people have. It's really, really, really quite amazing. Mm-hmm. And anyone that experiences homelessness and comes into these circumstances where it's really a game changer. Mm-hmm. Certainly was for myself.
Yeah.
So I also, Bethany, you know, people need to be more accountable for their lives, you know, and they need to. It's very embarrassing, you know, to talk about it. You know, hey, I'm homeless. Or we had two guests on from the teen homeless program through BCIU. I didn't mm-hmm. know that existed. Mm-hmm. This is another thing that I'm learning quite a bit. Mm-hmm. You know, that so much out there, and they're not wanting to talk to their peers about that. You know.
Oh, yeah.
And from my own experience, mm-hmm. you know, yeah. I came late to telling certain people that mm-hmm. could have possibly kept us out.
Yeah. When you're hoping to get young people involved, it's not always effective to use the term homeless, right? Instead, we define it. We say, you know, where are you sleeping from night to night? Oh, you slept on this friend's couch on Tuesday.
That's clever.
And this couch, right? You have to define it differently. You think about you being a young person, and vanity was important, right? Like, reputation was important, and so...
I wouldn't know anything about that.
We have to really meet people where they are, essentially. Right. So
that's very good. That's very good. That correlates with what we talked about earlier with the view that people have of homelessness. Mm-hmm. Maybe you know, you can describe it in another manner, right?
Yep. Yeah, you can.
It all means the same, pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Right. That's right.
So. What, if you may, in the last few minutes that we have, mm-hmm. could you give some encouragement to the public, to anyone that may be viewing the program, or someone that is, that could talk to a person who might be close to it, or is homeless for that?
Yeah, matter. I mean, I would say if you know someone in your life who is experiencing homelessness, I think you'd speak to them as a human being and the dignity and the worth of a person that they have and that they are, and speak to them from your heart. And listen without judgment and without making assumptions. While it's hard for us to do that, it's necessary. And to folks who may be feeling like you're experiencing some hardships with housing insecurity, I really hope that you would feel safe and comfortable reaching out to Family Promise. Like I said, if we don't know the answer or we can't help you, we try to find who can. We partner with many other nonprofit organizations in the community who we refer folks to often. And so I want you to feel Family Promise is a safe and a brave space to be.
Thank you. I don't think we mentioned this. Where you are.
Oh, we
and
are
if you have a phone number, sure. You could go
we
to the
are
website.
We are at 325 North 5th Street in the city of Reading, and our phone number is 610-373-3323, and our hours of operation are Monday through Thursday from 8:30 to 4:30 p.m.
Very good.
We'd love to hear from you.
Very good. Thank you very much for coming on the program. It's been very informative, to say the least.
Yeah.
And we really appreciate all of that.
Thanks for having us.
Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome. Thank you, Bethany. Thank you for watching the program. It's all available on YouTube, so we hope you watch. God bless.
Special programs on BCTV are supported by the following. Keystone Property and Asset Management provides expert care of industrial, office, retail, and medical sites. With more than 4 million square feet managed, Keystone knows how to save you money.